Hi guys, I wanted to show you this edit. So this is what we are going to do, and these are the layer masks. And the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go and select the layer mask I like, and it is this one. And I'm going to make sure it is highlighted, because when I drag the image, I want it to go straight on it. So here is the baby, and I'm going to grab my move tool, grab her, and bring her to the image, and I'm going to release her. She is really big, as you can tell, so I'm going to right click on here, on the gray part, not on the baby part, not on the picture file, right click, and create clipping mask. So she is going to be clipped to the layer mask below. Then I'm going to go edit and free transform, and I'm going to make her smaller. Make sure you don't distort the baby. If you have Adobe CC 2019 or newer, you do not hold shift. If you have older, you have to hold shift not to distort the baby. Okay. Now, I have a few problems here. I don't have enough from the background to cover the wings. And I also have, it's too transparent, so her face is kinda, I can keep it like that, actually, I like it, but I just wanna show you how you can fix this. Highlight the heart and grab a brush, B for your brush, and no matter the color, the color don't matter, but I'm going to grab the black color. It just looks, just like it better. Doesn't matter what color. I'm painting here on the clipping mask, so that is not transparent. If I paint here, she's not transparent, okay? So the other problem is I don't have enough from the background. I want the wings to be covered. Before my brush, this time I'm going to make sure this is active, click on it, and I'm going to sample from this color, which is close to her, and I have 100% opacity, 100% flow, and I'm going to paint really sloppy, because it's just going to show over the wings, since I have a clipping mask already. And the other side, the same thing. Sampling from somewhere here, because I want the color kind of to merge. So I have this clipping mask on purpose in normal blending mode. It is not in multiply, because I thought in this particular case I don't want the textures to show, and I want to paint in white, because those are angel wings and they look the best in white to me. So in order to have these wings visible, my background has to be darker color if I make them white. So I'm going to make the color of the background different. I wanted some kind of light, but not white. So I'm going to sample from the pitch color by holding my option key on my keyboard. I have a Mac, so option for Mac, Alpha PC. And I'm going to sample from this color, something peachy. Pink. That's a little too, I think I got it somewhere there. Come on. Okay, that's a little too dark. That's okay. So I'm going to, I sample the color, and I'm going to click here, because I want the new layer to be over the texture. That's the texture. So I have a new empty layer, and I'm going to change the blending mode to multiply. This color is a little bit too bright, too dark, so I'm going to go to the brighter side. Okay. So my brush should be in low opacity, something like this, 10-20%. Something of this sort is going to do. And I'm going to paint a little bit here. So it's not white, because I want, it's still not going to be contrasty, but I don't want it white. So some light color. I think my spacing is too small and my brush is kind of slow. Okay, I overdid it, so I'm going to grab my eraser E for my eraser E. I'm going to erase a little bit on the edge. Oops, that's a little too much. I want it sloppy. I would not paint it with this brush, but I don't know what kind of brushes we have. So let's say this. That looks good. And now I want the wings to be white so I can paint them a few different ways, but I'm going to do it this way this time. Activate her layer, and I'm going to grab the white X. In this case, I have white below, and I'm going to paint. Oops. Not going to erase, I have to paint. B for my brush, that was my eraser. Let me make it. So this is a little bit too strong. I'm going to reduce the opacity in a second. I just paint the edges right now in 100% opacity. Actually, I may like this. 100% opacity, 100% full, and I paint the edges. And I'm going to make that brush smaller, and I may paint this one too. Oops. And then I'm going to go with my brush in lower opacity and kind of slowly paint. Kind of blend it a little bit. Depends what you want. Somehow, somewhat, somewhere there. Okay, and that's pretty much like this. Then you know what? I'm just going to add an adjustment layer. See how her head is a little bit darker, her face. So I'm going to add an adjustment layer here. Levels. And let me just see. Oops. I have to clip that layer to her. Right click and create clipping mask. I don't want the entire thing to be affected by this adjustment. I just want her. So I'm just going to see how a little contrast is going to look on her, and it looks fantastic. I'm just brightening the brights, and look at the difference. That is her layer only. Looks fantastic, and I want to add a layer just for her face. So going there and levels. And again, I'm going to clip it to her. You can clip it to her by clicking here. It's going to clip it to the layer below. And I'm just going to make it a little bit wider. Then I'm going to go to image adjustment invert so it becomes black. And I'm going to paint it only over her face. 100%. Actually, I can go lower, paint it slower in white brush. And that's it. That's pretty much all. I'm not a fan of the yellow in this case, so you know what? I may add an adjustment layer, which is hue saturation, and clip it to her the same way by clicking here, because I want her only. And I'm going to grab the yellows, because those are all yellows, and shift it to the reds. And I'm going to remove it from her skin, B for my brush, and making sure I'm X to switch the colors, making sure low opacity brush, because I don't want 100%, so I want her to have the warmth, and that's a little too strong, so I'm actually going to reduce that opacity a little bit. And that's it. That's all. Thank you very much.